Here's your host, Alex Garrett.
Well, after some more health concerns and complications, which did lead me to the hospital, I'm back home, and maybe down the road we'll get into it. But before all the health stuff really escalated, there were three major things that happened in 3 days that I haven't even gotten to yet. And while I have a little energy, I wanted to talk about it today. Firstly, did you know that there's a Banksy Museum in honor of the street artist Banksy opened on 277 Canal Street? Yes, check it out. Here's a snippet of my conversation from the Banksy Museum. All right, well, I'm here at the Banksy Museum. You know, Banksy is such a mysterious figure, but I'm here with Executive Director William Mead. And for anybody who knows about Banksy, you know he keeps a very low, anonymous profile. You don't really know who he is, right? So how did you get him to agree to do all this work and put the museum together?
Well, the thing is that Banksy is an elusive figure. Nobody knows exactly who Banksy is. Nobody knows exactly where he comes from. Nobody knows his background and stuff. So what we actually did, we hired people to come in. And this entire exhibition was created anonymously. We have no idea who the people who created it are. We have no idea, but they have the direct connection to Banksy, and we don't.
Now, you obviously have an affinity for Banksy, right? That's kind of how this whole project started?
Well, you know, the thing is that how do we experience art now? How do we experience art? In all of this art is taken, here's a phrase that I really love, and it's called better out than in. Mm-hmm. We experience art in an art museum. We experience art in places that people tell us to experience art. His whole idea, take it out into the streets.
Yes, sir.
So, and all of a sudden, when you take it out into the streets, then people start ripping it down, or it's defaced, or that sort of thing. But he creates something that exists for the time. Mm-hmm. In 2013, he created 30 separate...
In New York alone.
Yeah. You know how many exist now?
How many?
One.
Right.
Right. One. Yeah. The girl up... The girl with the hammer up on 79th Street.
Okay, so I gotta go check that out.
It's the only one in Manhattan that exists at this point. All of them have been defaced or ripped down or taken away or something like that. So our purpose of this museum is really to honor works that would never be seen, and also to honor them in a way, as you can see, that we're doing here. We do it in the way closest to the way that it was originally done.
I highly recommend you check it out. 277 Canal Street, the Banksy Museum. And, you know, sometimes when I run around, my body does get a little worn down. And it was holding on. It was holding on because the next night, that was Wednesday, the next night, I ended up talking with a legend of the New York Yankees, Bam-Tino Martinez. Take a listen to a snippet of that conversation on the stage at the Viscardi Center, my old stomping grounds. And I was... had the honor, thanks to Dr. Chris Rosa and Laura Marzo, of interviewing Tino Martinez on that very stage I grew up on in Albertson, New York, at the Viscardi Center.
How did you adjust to New York after, you know, going
for not imagining anyone in those shoes? Well, as the Yankee fans here know, it was easy. And my first month here, I struggled a little bit just trying to get comfortable and get the fans' approval and the teammates' approval. And I spoke a little bit, and I heard the boos from the stadium for about a month straight. But I knew I wanted to play here in New York. I love Yankee Stadium. I love everything the Yankees stood for. And once I got comfortable and started hitting the ball, I did home runs and driving runs. And more importantly, the team started winning. Right? And then the fans started to really gravitate toward me.
Thanks to Larry Davis, my longtime friend and friend of Rene Grohn, and of course, the man who helped bring out Tino Martinez to the Viscardi Center that night on Celebrity Night, May 16th, for capturing that audio on the wings of the stage at Viscardi. And then the next night, so this was Wednesday, Thursday so far, and then the next night, a week ago Friday, someone very special got her master's degree at SUNY Empire State. That's right. My mom, Lori Sue Brockway, got her master's. She went from mastering motherhood to mastering in public history and then back to mastering motherhood, as she had to come into the hospital. And sure enough, I passed a gallstone this week. That's kind of the news. And there's been some complications from that, which is sidelining me for a little bit. But I'll be back out there soon enough. I'm just going to need some time to do some follow-ups. But I also want to say thank you to Mom and to Vic and to Gabby for getting me through this entire week. And once again, Mom, got to say this. Just to get her degree was a lot. And she had the support of my stepdad. But she really knocked out of the park, even through loss, even through health issues. And I'm so proud of her. And I just want to say that today on the Alex Garrett Podcast Network.